Guys, welcome back to this channel. So today we are going to be looking at another question on fluid mechanics on thermodynamic properties. So before I go on into solving this question, please subscribe to this channel and hit the notification button so you can get notified anytime I upload a new video. So now we are asked to find the density, the specific weight and specific volume of chlorine gas at 25 degrees Celsius and pressure of 600 kilonewton per meter square, given the molecular weight of chlorine as 71 and the universal gas constant as 8321 joule per kilogram per mole per Kelvin. So now let's get down to solving the question. So now, before we solve this particular question, we need to know the relationship or the thermodynamic relationship between the specific volume, the absolute pressure, and the density of a gas. So now, solution. So before we proceed, let's write out the parameters we are given in the question. So they gave us the universal gas constant, which I can represent as my large R, which is 8321 joule per kilogram mole per Kelvin, and it gave me my temperature, which is what? Temperature as 25 degrees Celsius. Now, converting 25 degrees Celsius to Kelvin, what are we going to be having? Converting 25 degrees Celsius to Kelvin, we are having 25 plus 273, which will give me 298 Kelvin, right? Now, these are the parameters, and my molecular weight of chlorine, which was given as, you can call it my large M, 71. So now these are the parameters we have in the question given. So now let's get down to solve. Now, like I said, before we solve, we need to know the thermodynamic relationship between absolute pressure, specific volume, and density. So that thermodynamic relation can be written as my pressure, which is my absolute pressure, divided by my density, is equal to my specific gas constant times my temperature. Now, before I proceed now, this is the specific gas constant, why they gave us the universal gas constant. So we now know that the universal gas constant is equal to the molecular weight times the specific gas constant. So universal gas constant is equal to molecular weight times specific gas constant. So universal gas constant given is what? 8321 joule per kilogram per mole per Kelvin. So we'll be having, and the molecular weight given here is what? 71. So we'll be having 71 times my specific gas constant. Now the universal gas constant given is what? 8321. So to get my specific gas constant, in order for me to suit this particular equation, divide both sides by 71, divide both sides by 71, we'll be having my specific gas constant is equal to 8321 divided by 71. We'll be having equal to 117.2 joule per kilogram per mole per Kelvin. So this right here is my specific gas constant. So now, since I have my specific gas constant, I can easily find my density. Remember, we're asked to find density, specific weight, and specific volume. Now, I've got to include in my parameters that we're giving our pressure to be what? 600 kilonewton per meter square. So, since I have my specific gas constant, I put it in the equation. So, my pressure, which we're given to be 600, in putting it in this particular equation, my pressure is what? 600 times 10 raised to the power 3 due to the kilo, and divided by the density, which I'm looking for, is equal to my specific gas constant, which is what, 117.2 times the temperature given. Temperature given is what, 298, right? So making my density subject of formula, my density right here is equal to 600 times 10 raised to the power 3 divided by 117.2 times 298. So solving this, we have 17.2 kilogram per meter cube. Now this right here is my density. So we move on to calculating my specific weight. So we all know that the specific weight, what's the formula for specific weight? Specific weight is equal to the weight over volume. Now, since we are given the density which is giving us 7.2 kilogram per meter cube, now converting the mass here to Newton, remember specific weight is weight over volume, and we have here as what, mass over volume. So we convert this mass to weight. Now converting my mass to weight, I'll just simply multiply it by my acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.81. So multiplying this by 9.81, this is 17.2 times 9.81 tons to Newton, then divided by my meter cube. So 17 times 9.81 gives me 168.7 Newton per meter cube. So this right here is my specific weight. So we move on to calculating my specific volume of chlorine gas at this that temperature. So what is the formula for calculating specific volume of a gas? So the formula for calculating specific volume is equal to volume all over mass. Right? So that's the formula for calculating specific volume. I repeat, the formula for calculating specific volume is volume over mass. So to get the volume over mass, I just simply is the inverse of my density. Since my density is equal to mass over volume, and specific volume is volume over mass, so that means specific volume is the inverse of my density. And I have my density right here as 17.2. So I can simply say specific volume is equal to 1 over 17.2, which will give me 0.0581 meter kilogram. That is the formula for the specific volume of chlorine gas given in the question. So with all that being said, that is the way to calculate the density, specific weight, and specific volume of chlorine gas at that temperature and pressure. So thank you guys for watching, and please subscribe.